Hey guys, how have you all been? It's been 2 months. We started putting videos back on YouTube now and on Instagram as well. And yeah, these 2 months were quite challenging for us. Starting to completely, rebrand ourselves. And I have obviously put out the video for the comeback or on why we were away for 2 months on the YouTube. You can check it out. But as I said in that video, like this comeback is very personal to me. And this is very personal, wherein we as coding at are trying to improve the student problems by giving them the actual solutions that they want. And yeah, from this video, we'll be having a couple of series of videos wherein we will be creating our first new project in the complete rebrand of coding at. And this particular project, and not particular this particular project, I can say the series of projects that we will be building will be the projects which will actually help you understand the details, the crux of how product is being developed, how should you think about when you are building a product, what are the steps you can follow when you are building a product or when you are building something, and what should be the approach. Okay, so yeah, we are pretty excited to show you all those things in the couple of videos. And yeah, in this video, we will be making a complete RAG model. Okay, and this RAG model will be able to chat with any particular YouTube video. Okay, so I have given the name as YouTube RAG, but let's see what the name would be. So yeah, I'll just show you and let's get into the demo purpose of this entire YouTube. So let's say we have this entire screen. Okay, I'll just go do one thing. I'll just go to coding and up, and let's say I want to talk with, let's say, greatest day of my life. Okay, I have this particular video. I'll just copy this video, okay, and I'll paste the URL over here. Okay, now what will happen is now I can actually chat with what are the contents of that particular YouTube video. Meaning, if the YouTube video is talking about, it's a generative AI and stuff, I'll ask, what is the YouTube video about? I just want to ask, what is the YouTube video about? So what it will do, it is going to send it. The RAG model will process what the user input is. Yeah, sorry. So it will send it. The YouTube RAG model will actually process what the input is and then give us the output. So let's see what the output is. The YouTube video is about generative AI and foundation models. The speaker discusses the introduction to generative AI, the architecture behind foundation models, their key capabilities, and their applications. The speaker also shares his experience about of using AI in project presentation to find similarities and differences between research papers. So let's say I want to ask one more thing. I'll ask, can you tell me more about foundation models? I just want to know more about foundation models. So rather than going to internet and finding out, it will just again go on to the YouTube video and then give us the output. So as you can see over here, foundation models are large scale models trained on raw data such as text, images, audio, and video. They are pre-trained at scale and have multi-model capabilities, which means they can use a combination of different types of content to create a whole product. These models are trained on millions of data points to ensure that they can answer user queries accurately and are often fine-tuned for specific use cases. Okay, so this is our entire video about, and this will be the project that we will be building. So before getting into the coding part, I want to share you one thing that, let's say, whenever you are creating a project, the first approach should never be, coding the project. Okay, like start with the coding. No, that is not the case, and that should not be actually the case for any kind of a project. The first thing should be the clarity. Like when you're building a project, you should have the clarity that, okay, this is the project that I want to create. These are the steps to be performed. So for that, I have created a step-by-step process. Okay, so the first step for our YouTube RAG project would be the first thing to access the URL from the user, because we want to chat with the YouTube video. So the first thing would be to get the YouTube video URL from the user. And then the next step is to now convert the URL and get the transcript of that video, because YouTube as a service provides transcript of all the videos that are available on YouTube. Transcript is basically a voice to text converted for a form of the things that are talked in the particular video. So the first thing is obviously to get the URL from the user. The second thing, to get the transcript from the URL. Okay. Once we are getting the transcript, what we will do is we will split the transcript into chunks. The reason being, whenever you are storing anything into your database, you cannot store a huge amount of transcript into the database. Okay. Each column that you create, it has a certain kind of a limit. So what we do is we kind of have, let's say we are having, I'll do one thing, we have, or not like this, my name is Aditya, I am from Coding Adda, I am a developer. Okay, so what I do is, this is just a short text, but just to explain, I have huge amount of data, I have a huge text, okay. So what I'll do here is, whenever I want to store it into a database, I'll split it into chunks. Okay, chunks meaning the first thing would be a chunk, this thing would be a chunk, or it can be, let's say my name is a chunk, then is Aditya, I am from would be a chunk, and then Coding Adda, I am a developer would be a chunk. So this is how we will be splitting the transcript into small chunks. Okay, now comes the part where we want to implement the entire RAG model. Okay, so implementing a RAG model is consisting of a series of steps. Okay, I'll just explain you these series of steps that are there. The first thing is, whenever you get a text or whenever you get an input, you have to convert them into embeddings. Embeddings are basically zeros and ones. I'll just show you. I'll just go to Google and I'll just write embeddings in RAG. Just a simple thing, and let's go into the images to explain you what are embeddings. Okay, we have, let's say, we have this particular image. This particular blog has an image. Where did it go? Yeah, I'll just open here. See, this is the text that we have. I am learning Gen AI. So that particular text is converted into zeros and ones. Okay. So this is how the first step is, whenever you are creating a RAG model, the first thing is to convert everything into an embedding. Okay, after converting it to an embedding, we have to store it in a database. The database that is required over here, or any kind of AI related project, whenever you want to store it into a database, the kind of database should be a vector DB. So what a vector DB? Let's understand. What are vector data? What are vector database? So I'll just go here. Vector database. Okay. So vector database is a special type of database designed to store, manage, and query high dimensional vector data, often used in machine learning and AI applications. So as I said, whenever we are creating an embeddings, these are zeros and ones. So these are in the form of a vector. Vector is the same thing that you learn in math. That is the thing that we are going to use over here. So vector database is required to store the vectors of the inputs or the text or the source data that we want to, you know, have a RAG or a conversation with. So the next thing is to convert the chunks into embeddings. And then here what we will have is this particular video. Okay, let's consider this particular video is as a document, because we will be chatting with it, right? So we will generate a document ID for this for any particular URL, and then store it into the Supabase database. Here we are using Supabase. So what is Supabase? Supabase is a Postgres development platform, and it is also a very good, you know, kind of a vector database. I use it for a lot of projects whenever I create a project, and it is very easy to use. It's as it said, it's a Postgres development platform. So it's one of the best database that I use and I have come across. So we will store it in Supabase database. The next thing is to get the user query. The user query means this. This is the user query that we will be taking as an input. Okay. And the next step, After taking the user queries as an input, we will be converting that query as well into an MVD, into a 0 and 1. And then, based on the user's question, there is a concept called similarity search. When we will be doing the similarity search, I will be explaining you what the similarity search as a concept is in detail. And then, once the similarity search is done, once we get the result, we will get the response and display it directly to the user. So this is going to be our entire workflow for creating this entire project. In the next video, we will be starting with creating the environment, creating the backend for the entire project, backend setup. The tech stack that we will be using is Node.js for the backend, Vite.js, V-I-T-E, Vite.js for the frontend, and Supabase for the database. And let's try to host this particular platform as well at the end of the video. If it hosts, and then it will be pretty good. If it does not host, we will try to debug it and see how the errors can be solved. So yeah, this was it for the particular video. If you like the video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And one thing that I would like to say is really thank you to each and everyone over the world who are supporting this channel. And we are really grateful for everything that you have done. And we will still be trying to, you know, give you a lot of projects and help the entire student community and the entire developer community. So yeah, with this, we'll see you in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.